Hello and welcome to the channel. I was just about to say welcome to the garage, but I've just realized I'm no longer in the garage. So welcome to the channel. I'm continuing my work on the electric car conversion using Toyota Prius inverter. So the previous videos, if you're interested to watch them, the link will be down in the descriptions below. So I will be working today on building up a supply source for the inverter. The choices I have is to actually have either have a power supply or a battery. So I think I'm looking to actually have both for my initial testing. So I will start today from building a battery modules. I will not be using them on the car actually, but I will be using them just to do the testing at this stage. So the battery modules I will be building from recycled laptop batteries, and I will show you the process I'm using to harvest my laptop batteries. I found it's actually easy to open the battery first by using DIY gloves and just sort of twist and turn the plastics and tear it off, as you could see on this video. Gloves also protect you from chance of injury. And after I've got rid of the plastics, I just snip off remnants of connection for the BMS. And now, once the cells are freed up, all I need to do is just to clean up some remnants of the glue and remaining nickel strips connecting the cells together. Here is the charger I use to test the cell's capacity. It will completely discharge and fully charge the cell to test the cell capacity. So I could list through the internal resistance, the time, the voltage, and the current that was used to charge the cell. So once it goes to 4.2, the cell is considered fully charged, and we can now see the capacity of the cell. I will be using these holders, and effectively we have 5x4 number of positions for the cells, and I'm planning to actually connect 10 in parallel and then have another 10 connected in serial. So effectively, this is how I want to position my cells. So I potentially may have 4.2 volts on this section, and then two of them will give me 8.4 volts. And I will need to put small improvised bus bar in the middle of these cells, and then in the middle of these cells. And also I'm going to be using these little resistors as a connections between the cell and the bus bar, because they will serve also as a fuse, because they will burn at high current. I was toying with numerous ideas on how to make bus bars, but it actually was taking so long, so I got really frustrated and just picked up one of the cables that I had lying around and just used that. I'm using domestic 3-wire single core cable, so I will just need to strip off the isolation and get the cores out. And ordinary Stanley knife was my power tool of choice, and it actually worked really well. The stripping went pretty smoothly and I got rid of the isolation very, very quickly. So these are my cells here, and I'm gonna use those bus bars that I've just made and just mount them like this. So these are not the best condition cells, but you know, I'm just gonna use these modules just for testing only. This will be our top, and one of the bus bars will go here. What I will want to do first is I want to do put a bit of flux on each cell, so it would be easier for me to solder it. And after that I can put my improvised bus bar. Well, it's not the best of the jobs I've done, but should do for now. So I'm just gonna secure it with a tape. Get my soldering iron ready. So at the same time, I don't want to warm up the battery too much, because basically it will cause some degradation. I know these cells are not the best ones that I have, but still I will still need to use them a bit, so I probably should have used the more powerful soldering iron, but it's the only one that I have. Okay, well, that's pretty much done. Now I can do the other side. From then on, I've done the other cells in a quick succession. Okay, so that side is done now. Okay, so I made another slightly different bus bar, so that goes in quite well in here. And a bit of tape. And now I will repeat the process here. Okay, so this is the bottom part of the battery module, and I'm placing the bus bar in this sort of position, and these are the minus connection for the cells and these are the plus connections. So effectively I will be connecting those 10 cells in series with those 10, so it will be 10P2S, so 10 parallel and two in series. Okay, so now I can use the tape. So I'm just gonna place the tape like this, just to temporarily secure it until I can solder. One more thing I want to do is I wanted to maybe just put additional little bus bar here and here, just to make sure we parallel them properly. And the last thing I needed to do is to wrap up my creation in heat shrink. So this will protect and cover all the contacts on the top, and it will make it look nice and neat. Well, this is all for this video. I hope I didn't bore you all to death. In the meantime, my electric car journey continues. I managed to purchase two Taika contactors, $25 each. So that was $50 for two of them, which is great. And yeah, if you like this video, please like, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.